Alright, welcome back. So, with today's lecture, we will close the discussion on magnetic circuit and mutual inductances. We already have studied magnetic circuits in reasonable detail. They create an electrical analog of they create circuits which are similar to electrical circuits. The MMFs mimic the EMFs and the reluctance mimics the resistance, and the MMFs follow the law similar to KVL, and fluxes follow the law similar to analogous to KCL. So we have solved some circuits also like that, and then we have defined self inductances, and we have also defined mutual inductances. And so in today's lecture, I am going to dive deep a bit more into dot convention for mutual circuits. You know, when you have multiple two or more coupled windings, as I have shown on the figure here, when you have multiple coupled windings like this, then these dots basically help us in writing the equations for the voltage drop across these coils, and then I will solve some example at the end of it. So for the time being, let's do one thing. Let's relegate this figure to for the later discussion. So let me paste it here, and let me only take two coupled coils let me start with two coupled coils instead of three coupled coils. I'm sorry. Of course, I can do that thing just by making I3 equal to 0, but that's not what I want to do. Aesthetically, I think this looks better. So let's start with this. I have two coupled coils, coil 1 and coil 2. Okay. And I have shown that current is entering coil 1 as I1 here and coil 2 as I2 here. And the way I have wound the coil is very clear. I have talked about how to wind the coil in the previous lecture also. So that is very clearly shown here. The first thing that you should do is you should check what is the direction of the flux that will be created by each of these coils when the current enters it. So again, a right-handed screw, if you rotate it, you will find that this both the coils, because they are wound exactly in the same way, and the currents are entering also exactly in the same way from the top end. So therefore, they will create additive fluxes phi1 and phi2 that in the directions shown. Since we are treating right now coils to be ideal, so coils to be ideal, so all the flux that links coil 1 also links coil 2. Of course, if there is some leakage which is created here, shown deliberately by very light yellow arrows, then it will not be so. But for the time being, I'm going to ignore the leakage. These are sort of parasitic effects that we consider at the end. Okay. So, first of all, what is the flux phi1? Let us say that this flux can be written as phi11, which is the flux in coil 1 due to current in coil 1 due to due to current in coil 1 plus phi 1 2, where again the first indicator is in coil 1 and the second phi 2 indicates due to current in coil 2. So I'll just mark it here as due to I2. So it's due to I2. So the first symbol is, so I'm writing it as phi E is the effect and C is the cause. That is the convention that I am following. Similarly, then phi 2 can be written as net flux in this left hand side is the total flux in the windings is going to be equal to phi 2 1 plus phi 2 2, the flux in the coil 2 due to current in the coil 1, which is the first term, and flux in the coil 2 due to current in the coil 2, which is the second term. Okay. Now let's write the flux linkages. Lambda 1 is N1 phi 1. So therefore, it is going to be N1 phi 1 1 plus N1 phi 1 2. And similarly, lambda 2, which is N2 phi 2, is going to be N2 phi 2 1 plus N2 phi 2 2. So these are going to be the flux linkages, which I will further write it in a more simplified notation as lambda 1 lambda 2 is going to be equal to, actually I don't need this matrices still, so I can avoid the matrix notation still. So the lambda 1, the flux linkage is lambda 1 1, N1 phi 1 1 is the lambda 1 1 plus lambda 1 2, and lambda 2 is equal to lambda 2 1 plus lambda 2 2. So alternately I can now write the equation in the lambda form as follows. Now what is self-inductance? The self-inductance, basically, as if there is no other coil, that's the notion. It's only the effect due to the self. So as if nothing else is there. So therefore, if you want to calculate the self-inductance of coil 1, then what you should do? You should set I2 to 0. When you set I2 to 0, then what will you get? What will you get? Flux linking the coil 1 is nothing but equal to phi 1 1, because there is nothing coming from, no contribution coming from this, and there this also implies that lambda 1 is N1 phi 1 1, and what is phi 1 1? The MMF N1 I 1. The MMF N1 I1 by the reluctance of this path. The reluctance of this path, which is N1 square by the reluctance times I1. This is lambda 1. And therefore, we had earlier itself defined this as L1. So the L1 becomes equal to N1 square by the common reluctance of this, rather not the common reluctance, the total reluctance which is seen by this coil 1. In this case, there is only one reluctance that we need to worry about. Okay. Similarly, L2 is going to be N2 square by R, Now the coil 2 is only there. Current I1 is set to 0. Since the currents are going in a way, exactly similar way, geometry is same, so I don't need to do another derivation. I can just write this as N2 square by R. If the geometry seen are different, you would need to do two different derivations. But here the geometry is same. So L1 and L2. Now let's come to the mutual effect. Suppose I have excited current I2 is 0 and I1 is excited, say 1 ampere or what. I have excited the I1 is excited. So then there is an effect. What is my notation? Effect comes first, cause comes later. So there is an effect phi 2 due to cause 1. And what is that effect? What is the cause? Cause is, see, phi 2, this flux which is the flux which is created here, the same flux comes back here and connects here. So therefore the flux is the common flux here. So therefore I can write this flux as the cause which is MMF N1 I1 divided by, there is only one, by the reluctance R, and so phi 2 1 also becomes equal to N1 I1 by R. Now the flux linking the coil 2 due to the current in the coil 1 will be N2 times of phi 2 1. Right, I have shown it here. N2 times of N2 times of phi 2 1. So the N2 times of phi 2 1 will become equal to, substitute the above equation, N1 N2 by R times of I1, which is now can be written as mutual inductance M21. M21 times I1, correct? So now I have defined the mutual inductance parameter. It is saying that it is the flux, it is the ratio of flux linking the second coil due to current in the first coil with no current excitation in the second coil. Only one coil is excited, which is the cause coil, the current coil 1, and it causes flux in the flux linkages in the coil 2, and the ratio of the flux linkages in the coil 2 divided by the current in the coil 1 is the mutual inductance M21. Similarly, if you write lambda 12, you would get it as, and I leave it to you to work it out, exactly same thing you are going to get. A simple way of saying everything else is same, geometry is same, completely same reluctances, everything is same. So a simple way of describing it would be just interchange the symbols, so letters, numerals 1 and 2, and you will get lambda 12, N2 will become N1, N1 will become N2, so the product still remains N1, N2, divided by the reluctance, the current I1 will become I2. So you will get this. Now, so you will get this as M12 I2. Clearly, M12 is equal to M21 is equal to N1 N2 by the reluctance. And therefore, you can call it as one common mutual inductance, one, M. So, between two coils, we only have one common mutual inductance, M. Now, if leakage is accounted as I had done earlier, if the leakage is accounted, all the flux here, some leakage flux will come happen here, and hence all the flux which is created by the winding 1 will not go and link winding 2, and vice versa when the other one is not carrying any current. So therefore you will not be you will not be able to write what I did here, phi 21 to be exactly equal to n1 I1 by R, something less will, only something, a fraction of this will come here. And hence, the inductance will not exactly get this value, but that small fraction, that little bit, 99%, 98%, whatever, that fraction will come here also. So the mutual inductance will be slightly less than N1 N2 by R. Hence, usually, now we know that L1 is N1 square by R, L2 is N2 square by R. So M becomes under root of L1 L2 under ideal conditions, but actually it will be slightly less, and this factor is called as the coefficient of coupling K, which is less than 1. So ideally it will be 1, but actual practice it will be less than 1. Fine. I think so far I have discussed some of these concepts with you earlier also, so you are comfortable with them. Now my next job is to write voltage equations. So to write the voltage equations now, that's my next job for this. So V1, let's take the coil 1, V1, and I want to write the voltage. What is V1? V1 is d psi 1 by dt, where psi 1 is the net flux linkage with respect to the coil 1. But how did I write psi 1 earlier? Psi 1 1 plus psi 1 2, where the first term indicates that the cause is current in the coil 1 and linkage is also created in the coil 1, and the second term is cause is the current in the coil 2 and linkage is created in the coil 1. So therefore, I can again write this first term as, when the cause and the effect are the same, what comes into picture is self-inductance. So lambda 11 can be written as L1 I1, and when the cause and the effect, cause is in one coil and the effect is in the other coil, then what comes into picture is the mutual inductance, the cause being current in the coil 2 and mutual inductance being symmetric, M12 equal to M21. I can just use M here, there are only two coils. So I'll just write it as M into what is the cause, the current in I2. So I can write this as L1 di1 by dt plus M di2 by dt. Now, similarly, V2 can be written as L2 di2 by dt plus M di1 by dt. Okay. Now notice this fact here. Let me copy this figure to the next page. So now let us see here two things you note. I want you to focus on one thing. Why this plus sign is coming here? This V1 here is written as L di1 by dt plus M di2 by dt. The reason that this plus sign is coming is because the currents entering the two coils are creating additive fluxes. This is the reason why this particular thing is coming. So this fact is captured by putting two dots here, and the rule that we are going to follow is the following. If current entering the windings produce additive fluxes, put dots at the tips of the arrows, tips of the arrows of entering currents, else put the dot at the other end. Now when the dot comes, so here the plus is because both the currents are entering the dotted terminal, so this current creates a voltage drop here. Similarly, the impact of this current is also to create a voltage drop only in the same in this coil. Therefore, the voltage when this applied voltage has to balance the induced EMFs due to the self-inductance and the mutual inductance. Since both of them act in an identical additive manner, a plus M has come here. And the same thing happens with respect to this. Suppose I had changed the polarity. I have given you, you see, the reason why people give dot polarity is because your windings would be wound in certain way, then if the currents entering it are producing additive fluxes, then the dots will be put there. After that, let's say you wrap it in a nice box, cover it up, everything. Now the winding details are not shown known to you from outside, so you are not able to peep in, just like you can't peep in the engine because engine is encased, you know, in the car bonnet and so on and so forth. Similarly, here also, once everything is encased, nicely packed, so on and so forth, only thing that you are given is this dots. So looking at the dots, you know that if the currents enter the dots, they will produce additive fluxes, and if they are that's what you come to know. Now suppose you decide, however, to put however let's say that you decide to put current I2 in this way. If you put this current I2 in this way, what happens to this I2? I'll write I2 under bar. Okay, let's to keep things simple. Then the I2 under bar will come out of this place. So now what is the relationship between I2 under bar and I2? It is minus of I2. So therefore, in terms of I2 bar, what would happen to this equation? It will become now V1 is equal to L1 di1 by dt minus M di2 bar by dt. And similarly, V2 will become L2 di2 bar by dt minus of M di1 by dt. See, let me explain the second equation for a change now. First term, current is entering here, okay, I2 bar. This creates a drop due to the self-inductance of the coil. The self-inductance of the coil will always create a drop in the direction of the current. So, therefore, you will get this L2 di2 bar by dt. Now, the current entering here creates a flux इन अपोजिशन टू द करंट विच इज एंटरिंग हियर एंड देयर फॉर लिविंग हियर. सो द अदर वे टू से इट इज, इफ आई एसोसिएट अ प्लस वोल्टेज विथ हियर, आई विल एसोसिएट अ प्लस वोल्टेज विथ हियर. सो वेन आई एम ट्रेसिंग द लूप इन दिस पर्टिकुलर वे, वॉट विल आई सी? आई विल सी अ वोल्टेज राइज. सो द वोल्टेज ड्रॉप इफ इट इज टेकन एज पॉजिटिव, द वोल्टेज राइज विल बी टेकन एज निगेटिव एंड देयर फॉर माइनस एम विल कम. सो दिस इज बेसिकली कॉन्सिक्वेंस ऑफ द फ्लक्सेस नॉट बींग एडिटिव इन नेचर बट रादर सब्ट्रैक्टिव इन नेचर. सो दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट डॉट कन्वेंशन दैट वी नीड टू फॉलो. नाउ लेट्स टेक थ्री कॉइल्स हियर. सो लैम्डा वन विल बी इक्वल टू लैम्डा वन वन प्लस लैम्डा वन टू प्लस लैम्डा वन थ्री. लैम्डा टू विल बी लैम्डा टू वन प्लस लैम्डा टू टू प्लस लैम्डा टू थ्री. वी हैव टू डिसाइड एक्चुअली प्लस एंड माइनस साइंस. लेट मी आई एम सॉरी, आई जंप द गन हियर. फर्स्ट लेट मी पुट द डॉट्स. लेट मी टेक सम थिकर वन. ओके, नाउ इफ यू लुक एट इट, the phi 1, phi 2 and phi 3, the way I have wound they, and the way the currents are shown to be entering, they are creating additive fluxes. Fine. So if I have a dot here and this current entering is also creating an additive flux, then these two dots will come like this. Similarly, if I have, just for the sake of current entering here and the current entering here, they are also creating additive fluxes. So I will keep these two sets of dots here. Now the current entering here, in this case I have simplified it a lot, and the currents entering here are again creating additive fluxes. So therefore I will create another set of dots like this. Now see, for every pair I need one set of dots, right? That's the basic idea. So in this three coil system I had three pairs of currents, so I need three colors. I needed three dots is what I needed. I should also probably add a red dot here, because the current entering here and the current entering here are creating additive fluxes. Current entering here, current entering here, current entering here, current entering here creates additive fluxes. Here and here creates additive fluxes. This and this is also creating additive fluxes. So I have everything else gets explained. So now let us write the equation. Lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3 can be written as, lambda 1 1 can be written as, I'm going to directly write it in a matrix format now. I1, I2, I3. So L1 I1 plus m plus m12 i2. What is m12 i2? The m12 i2 is the, because this flux is current entering i2 will create flux in a very similar way to current entering i1. So the if the first one creates a drop effect, the second one also creates a drop effect, and it is m12 is the mutual coupling between coil 1 and 2, and so you get this equation. And then similarly m13 and plus lambda 13 can be written as m13 i3. So now notice that I need to give subscripts to my mutual inductances, because different pairs are involved. And let me just complete it for you. I leave it to you to complete the remaining terms. L3 I3. So this is what comes out to you in the matrix form. Now suppose that this I2 was shown to enter from this term. Then what you could do is, see, first you could just write equations assuming that all currents are entering the dotted terminals. Then you will always get equation with a plus sign like this. But now here I have shown to you that the I2 is entering the other one, which means that this I2 is going to come out from the other one. So if I2 is going to come out from the other one, it is like saying that I2 is replaced by minus I2. So therefore, if I replace this with minus I2, effectively, then mutual inductance term will become minus here, because the current entering this term is leaving this, is creating a negative flux here. So therefore this will come with minus, and the third one still remains the plus. Now if this is the minus, the same impact will be seen in the other way round also. So you will get minus of M21 L2 plus M23 I3, and then the third one is, what about M23? Yeah. So for the M23 also I will have to change the sign, is it not? So for the M23 also, because of the fact that the I2 and flux creating impacts are in opposition, so I will have to change that. I think let me do it a slightly better way. No, let me do it like this. I'm not very happy with the way I explained to you. So first assume that let us write that all entering currents are shown by I1, a fictitious case that all the currents are entering the dotted terminals, and so which I am going to call them as I1 bar, I2 bar and I3 bar, in which case all the fluxes tend to be additive, and because all the fluxes tend to be additive, so I get an equation in the additive form like this. Now I write that I1 bar is equal to I1, I2 bar actually is equal to, because the I2 is coming out, really speaking, from the dotted terminal. So I2 bar becomes minus I2, and I3 bar remains same as I3. So now I substitute it there. So I get lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3 is equal to L1. So if I write instead of, so I have to write it here as I1 minus I2 and I3. So L1 M12 M13 L2 M21 M23 L3, M31, M32, which is same as M23 and then L3. So I1 has to be just I1 bar is now, I2 bar is replaced by I2 bar. Now you change introduce. Now you can actually take this minus sign to the second column. So therefore minus M12, M13, M21. Now you will see here minus L2 and M23 and M31 minus of M32 and L3, I1, I2, I3. So there is something more that I need to do. What is it that I need to do? First of all, one more correction I had to do. First of all, when I have this as I1 bar, I2 bar and I3 bar, I should have written this as L1 bar, L2 bar, lambda 1 bar, lambda 2 bar and lambda 3 bar. Okay. Then I will get lambda 1 bar to be equal to lambda 1, lambda 2 bar, because the voltage polarities are also changed, you know, when you push the current from the other side, you have to also reverse the voltage. So the lambda 2 bar is also going to be equal to minus of lambda 2, and lambda 3 bar is going to be same as lambda 3. So therefore, I have to also put a minus sign here, and hence now I am getting this equation as lambda 1 minus lambda 2 and lambda 3 equal to this. Now you write lambda 2, lambda 1, lambda 3 as no change will happen in the first equation. In the second equation, you can multiply the second equation by minus 1. When you multiply the second equation by minus 1, this will become the second equation. What will happen to the second equation? Minus of M21 L2 minus of M23, and then third equation remains the same, and L3 I1, I2, I3. But minus of M21 and M12 being same, so this is like this. Minus of M23 and M32 being same, so this is also like this. So now you can see that the connecting mutual inductance matrix or the inductance matrix. So you can finally write this as lambda vector of flux linkage vectors of the coil can be written, 3 cross 1 vector can be written as a inductance matrix L, which is 3 cross 3 matrix, times the current vector I, which is a 3 cross 1 matrix. And this L matrix is always going to be symmetric. This is very important. If I was making a mistake earlier, then I was finding that the matrix was not symmetric. So what did I realize? I realized that I did something on the current directions rightly on the substitution on the right hand side, but I didn't do that thing correctly on the flux linkage on the left hand side, and hence that problem had come. So I immediately went back and corrected it. Now V1 is going to be equal to just, what is it, d lambda 1 by dt. V2 is going to be equal to d lambda 2 by dt. And where is V2 applied in this particular case? Here is V1, here is V2. The voltage is pushing the current into the coil. That's the normal convention. So therefore V3 is d lambda 2 by dt, and V3 is d lambda 3 by dt. So V1, V2, V3, because in my this L matrix is a constant matrix. There are no rotating parts so far. So the L matrix is just a constant matrix. So therefore, this will be di1 by dt, di2 by dt, and di3 by dt. So this is the way I go about writing these equations. Now let me take one concrete example. So the example that I am taking here, this is something I had given in the grade improvement sheet last time. So in the network of the figure shown below there, all the self inductances are 1 Henry. So self inductance L1, L2, L3 are each one Henry. Find L equivalent. Find L equivalent, the equivalent inductance shown in figure B. So basically, we are equivalencing at the terminals 1 to 2. There is only one set of terminal which is made available. Whole of this thing, we want to show by 1 L equivalent. So let's do that. Let me go to the okay, let me take this. Let's solve this problem now. So I'm going to write two loops. There are two basic loops that I need to solve. I have chosen this one loop as this one and other loop as this one. The third loop, which could also have been written, is just the summation of 1 and 2 and hence is redundant. We don't need to write it. Since all the self inductances are 1 and the mutual inductance is half, it is clear that coefficient of coupling in this case is half. Okay. The dots are already given to you. These two dots, currents are entering these two dots. And here the I2, because it's shown to enter here in my circuit, it will be leaving this particular dot. So the mutual effects here are additive. The mutual effects here are subtractive. Similarly, the mutual effects here are also subtractive, but the mutual effects here are additive. Okay. Now, current I1 is going to be equal to I2 plus I3. So, this is my first equation. So, I can write di1 by dt equal to di2 by dt plus di3 by dt. That is writing the KCL for this particular node. Now let us write KVL for the node loop 1 and then we will write KVL for the loop 2. So let's write the KVL for the loop 1. Applied voltage V on the left hand side is equal to, first I will just write the self inductance drop. So di1 by dt, 1 times di1 by dt, this is here, plus 1 times di2 by dt, because the current is entering in this direction. So the plus and minus voltages are going to be, for V2 will be written in this direction. Here also plus minus are written in this direction. So they are all additive across in the direction of the loop. So di1 by dt plus di2 by dt. Now let's look at the mutual coupling impact. So the voltage here in this coil will be due to mutual coupling in this coil and this coil. So what is the impact of di? So half of di, since the mutual couplings are all 1 by 2, so all mutual these things are half of di by dt. I just need to write the correct I subscript here. So for example, for the first coil, if I take due to I3, it will be plus of half of di3 by dt. And if I take due to I2, because the mutual voltage is in because of mutual inductance, voltage drop will be induced in this coil. That will have contribution from both coil 2 and coil 3. So I need to write two terms when I actually say drop in the coil 1. The drop in the coil 1 has three terms, one coming of its own and the two coming out due to contributions from coil 2 and coil 3. So the one of its own, I have written it here. This is the one due to the coil 3, and minus half here is due to the coil 2. Why is this with plus half? Because I1 and I3 are entering the dotted terminal, so they act in the same way. And why is it minus here? Because I1 and I2 are now, I1 is entering the dotted terminal and I2 is leaving the dotted terminal. So when one enters the dotted terminal and another current leaves the dotted terminal, we have to associate the minus sign here. Now let's come to the second coil. Di2 by dt, that is the voltage drop, self-inductance based voltage drop in the coil 2. And now the contributions due to coil 1 and coil 3. So with respect to coil 1, current is entering coil 1. With respect to coil 3, coil 2, current is leaving the coil 2. So therefore, a negative term will come, minus half of di1 by dt. Why? Di1 by dt, because now you are looking at the voltage drop in coil 2 due to current in coil 1. And now the last term that is left is the contribution of the induced voltage in coil 2 due to current in coil 3. Now current entering, current is I3 enters coil 3 while the I2 leaves coil 2. So therefore the term used here is minus of half, and therefore minus half of di3 by dt. So in this interesting example, what happens is this half cancels with this half. So the V becomes equal to, so the V becomes equal to half of di1 plus half of di2 by dt. Now let's write the equation for loop 2. So in the loop 2, is there any source? There is no source here in the loop 2. So everything is like here it was V, here everything will just sum to 0. So it's like 0 equal to all this which I have written here. Instead of that, I have just put the equal to 0 on the right hand side. Now in the direction of the loop, current I3, the self-inductance drop in this coil is positive. So I get a plus 1 times of di3 by dt, but I2 current is entering like this and the drop will not actually happen. It is, what is going to happen is actually the rise which is going to happen. So you get a term which is minus of di2 by d3, because in this direction the current is flowing in this direction and the loop is closing in the opposite direction. So therefore you get minus di2 by d3. Now self inductances are taken care of. Now we have to, basically what I meant to say is if current is entering here, then I would be associating a plus sign here and a minus sign here for the inductive element, which going in this direction is an increase in the voltage, and the increase in the voltage is shown by a minus sign here. So that's why here the self inductances are not directly coming positive. One self inductance is coming positive, another is coming negative. Now let's look at coil 2 and add the remaining remaining voltage terms. So okay, let me take the coil 3 first. In the coil 3, this term is positive, self-inductance drop is positive. Due to coil 2, the current is leaving the dotted terminal, will create a negative negative terminal here, and therefore will create a negative contribution which is minus half of di2 by dt coming here. And what about coil 1? Coil 1, I1 is entering the dotted terminal. So impact of this will be a plus and a minus here, which is the same as the self additive fluxes, same similar impact. So therefore you will get half of you will get half of di1 by dt. So in I3, this is the contribution due to the coil 2. This is the contribution due to coil 1. Now, with respect to coil 2, the current is entering this particular terminal. So therefore, if this current is entering this terminal, it is going to create a plus voltage here and a minus voltage here, which is additive in the direction of the loop. So you get a plus half of di1 by dt. And similarly, this entering current will create a plus polarity here and a minus polarity here. So therefore you will get another di3 by half of di3 by d3. So now you can group it together and you get this simplified equation. You can just check it out. And then you can further substitute I1 is equal to you can write di1 by d2 in terms of di2 by dt and di3 by dt, and then substitute for di1 for this di3, you can substitute from this equation in terms of i1 and i2, and once you have got this, you will get this nice simple equation that di2 by d2 dt is equal to 5 by 6 of di1 by dt. And hence, once you got this equation, then go back to this first equation. V was half of di1 by dt plus half of di2 by dt. Substitute it here. For di2 by dt, substitute 5/6 of di1 by dt, and you will get V is equal to 11 by 12 di1 by dt, which means that L equivalent is 11 by 12. So the L equivalent is 11 by 12. So here is a small simple last problem for you that I am leaving you with a last problem for you to do it. Let me not even draw this. Okay, let's say I have two mutually coupled coils. This is a self exercise. This is M, mutual inductance is L1, L2, as are dots, and I connect these two coils in series so that L equivalent is equal to L1 plus L2 plus 2M. Now, let's change the way they are connected. So this one jumps here and enters here. Everything else remaining the same. And comes out from here, and then I connect the current I, V, V. Now show that this is L1 plus L2 minus of 2M. So you should show L1 plus L2 plus minus of 2M. One last thing that I think I want to do, this is not the file, where is that file that I was, notability, recent notes, is this the file, last thing that I want to do here is, let's say this is I1. Okay. This is I2. This is carrying and the mutual inductance is M, L1 and L2. Let's just see what is the energy stored in such a mutually coupled coil. Quickly do that. So V1 is going to be equal to d lambda 1 by dt, which is L1 di1 by dt plus m times of di2 by dt. Now power P1 is V1 I1, the energy pumped by the source 1 V1 and the energy pumped by the source 2 V2. So P1 is V1 I1 is going to be L1. In fact, let me directly write the dE1 as P1 dt is V1 I1 dt. So therefore L1 I1 di1 plus M I1 di2. Similarly, the energy associated with the coil 2, incremental energy that will be pumped into coil 2, magnetic field energy which will be pumped into coil 2 due to will be P2 d dt, and P2 is going to be V2 I2. P2 is going to be V2 I2. So therefore V2 I2 d dt, P2 dt is V2 I2 d dt. For V2 I can write it as L2 di2 by dt plus M di1 by dt times of dt. So therefore this is going to be equal to L2 and then this is I2, sorry, missing. So L2 I2 di2 plus M I2 di1. So therefore dE, the net electrical energy which is pushed into this, is going to be equal to sum of the two. So therefore L1 I1 di1 plus M I1 di2 plus L2 I2 di2 plus M I2 di of 1. And now if to integrate it, if the current goes from 0 to I1 here, the current goes from 0 to I2 here, the current goes from 0 to I2 here, and the current goes from 0 to I1 here. So what will happen to this? Half of Li1 square, since this is an integration done with respect to I2, this is an integration done with respect to I2 and here is I1, so no squaring term is going to happen. So this is going to be simply M I1 I2 plus half of L2 I2 square plus M I1 I2. So therefore the net energy E which is going to be stored in such a magnetic circuit is half of Li1 square plus half of Li2 square plus 2M I1 I2. Now it is clear that if one current is made to enter a dotted terminal and another is made to leave a dotted terminal, then one I2 will be replaced by minus I2. So this whole thing will be replaced by a minus symbol. Here if I just change the current polarity in this particular coil. Now it is, if only one coil is excited, then we get the standard expression that energy is half Li square. But when there are two currents and a mutually coupled coil, then it is not just the sum of the energy stored due to self inductances, but a contribution also coming out of mutual inductances. Let's stop here with this. Thank you.